While excavating the Silver River, archaeologist Sean Joy had a close wildlife encounter.
Like six manatee came out, kind of circled around Morgan, and I really think it didn't see me. And it just kept coming and coming, and I was like, right at the last minute, scooted off. But it was like almost touching my nose, you know?
Most of the excavation crew is students. They have fun in their digs, but they're serious about their work.
Let me give a little kudos to these students. They're disciplined scholars. They're paying attention to the methodologies that are necessary. You know, working archaeology underwater is more complex, and so they're handling all the issues.
We work really well together, this crew that we have, and we have a great time doing it. We have a lot of fun doing archaeology because everybody on this crew really loves archaeology.
This crew is searching for the identity of the first people to inhabit the Americas. They're finding answers and more questions in Florida rivers. On the Wacissa River, Morgan is looking at an Ice Age culture whose world was rapidly changing.
The Ryan Harley site is a really unique site located on the lower Wacissa River in North Florida. And it was reported by Ryan and Harley Means.
These are all duck skeletal elements, duck fossils. This river contains archaeological and paleontological materials everywhere, up and down its course.
Harley is the assistant state geologist, and Ryan Means is a wildlife biologist. He works for the Coastal Plains Institute. They were swimming along in the river one day, and they found these isolated Swanee-style projectile points. And the thing that's really fascinating about Swanee is they're an excellent correlate for adaptation to climate change, like we're seeing right now, because Swanee people would have witnessed the most dramatic climate change the Earth has seen in recent memory. You know, you have Swanee points 100 miles out on the coast, and you have Swanee points inland. The really significant thing right now about Ryan Harley is that these artifacts are in direct association with these species that went extinct at the end of the last ice age. About 12,700 years, you know, maybe plus or minus 100 or so. This is one of very, very few sites where Swanee has actually come from in situ in context associated with other things.
Older archaeological sites make news. But for dates to mean anything, there has to be context.
We need three things in the archaeological community to present it as a true site of association between man and people. We need unequivocal artifacts, we need absolute radiocarbon ages, and we need secure geologic context.
Last week, we visited two of Morgan's sites on the Silver River. These sites and Ryan Harley have artifacts. All three have organic material that can be carbon dated.
This is probably a juvenile or calf. Mammoth tooth plate, so that's like, boom, done, you know?
Yeah.
But for the radiocarbon dates to tell Morgan anything about the age of an artifact, the artifacts have to be found in the ground, in context with the organic material.
Unfortunately, it looks like the context that's needed for a secure archaeological site isn't present within the cavern, so it's really difficult to say whether or not that is a legitimate association, although it could be. There's no question at all that the mammoth is associated with the artifacts physically. The question is whether or not temporally they're associated, whether or not people actually interacted with these mammoths, or whether or not these artifacts and the mammoth bones came to be associated by geological processes or by riverine processes. And that's what we're testing now. I started excavating Ryan Harley as part of my dissertation. I was following on the footsteps of Jim Dunbar, who directed a project there in the late 1990s. What they found originally was a discrete Swanee layer, so nothing but Swanee material, you know, buried shallowly in a not too deep section of the Wacissa River. As we're excavating, we maintain straight walls as much as we can, you know, so that we can clean off a really nice profile of the sediment layers, and we can go through at the end and kind of map them all in and figure out how they interact and figure out, you know, how this sediment layer was deposited. We can also pluck radiocarbon datable material out of that wall and start to build a chronology of the geologic layers of the site.
There are dozens of archaeological sites on the Osceola and Wacissa rivers. One reason is that water preserves bones and artifacts well.
Because if you go on land out here and you dig a meter deep pit, all you're going to find is sand. There's going to be no organic material in it. It's hot, it's cold, it's wet, it's dry all the time on land. then you don't get the stability that you really need for organic preservation. Underwater, you get that stability. You know, the pH of a lot of Florida's rivers is pretty consistent throughout the year. The temperature is pretty consistent from around 65 to 72 degrees all year round, no matter what. And there's constant sediment deposition in rivers, so you're getting the sediment laid down sequentially over time.
Another reason why the Southeast has so many old sites could be the reason that many of us live here.
You know, a lot of people are here nowadays, it's the same thing. This is a really great place to live. You know, it's not that cold, but on the other hand, you can have a nice fire in the winter. There's a ton of food. At the time Paleo Indians were here, the environment was quite a bit different, but still yet real conducive. So we think that the springs were flowing at least enough to draw the animals and the people and stuff. Supposedly the temperatures would have been a bit lower. It probably was really, really nice.
There is all this submerged prehistoric sites in the Gulf of Mexico and all our continental shelf.
Actually, we haven't gone out to the offshore yet, but that's where they want to go. We have a grant going right now. We're writing at the moment to do that work.
For WFSU, I'm Rob Diaz de Villegas.